Hello guys, my name is Hardwinder. Today we are going to cover the topic number conversion. This is a topic of first lesson, class 7th. What is number system? The types of number system we have already covered in the previous session. In this session we will learn how to convert the number decimal to binary, binary to decimal, octal to decimal, and hexadecimal to decimal. These conversions we will learn in this session. Conversion into decimal to binary number system. Why we need to convert this decimal number to binary number? Because the computer can understand. In the previous session we have already discussed, computer can understand only the binary language, means digital signals 0 and 1, and as a human being we can understand decimal numbers. Like 5856 is a decimal number. We need to convert it into a binary number 10110000. So these number 5856 is for you, for human beings. They can understand this, but computer can't understand this. For computer, we need it to convert it into a binary, and for making to understand to human being, it needs to be converted into a high level language, means in a decimal form. Our types of number system we have already covered in the previous system. Decimal number system, commonly used number system, mostly we use in daily life, that is a decimal number system. It consists of 10 digits 0 to 9. There are 10 digits, don't forget, include 0. For example, 107, 78, 982, 786. You can see every individual digit will lie between 0 to 9. Similarly, binary number system, you know, this is a digital, computers can understand only, and these are only two digits, 0 and 1, the base 2, as you can see in the example. Then hexadecimal number system, it consists of 16 digits, 0 to 9. Digits and A to F alphabets, total 16 digits, 0 to 15. 0 to 9 will be denoted by digits, and 10 to 15 will be denoted by alphabets. 10 means A, 11 means B, 12, 13, 14. These are denoted by alphabets: A 10, B 11, C 12, D 13, E 14, and F 15. So these are the examples, and you can see D I C E. D denotes the A 10, B 11, C 12, D 13. D denotes 13. Then 1. Then C. C denotes what? 10A, 11B, and C is 12. Then E denotes the 14. Similarly, 2E6 means 2, 14, and 6. Octal number system consists of 8 digits 0 to 7, base 10, 8, and all individual digits will lie between 0 to 7. Why we need to convert the decimal number into binary number? We have already discussed. High level language is a decimal language, is a high level language which human being can understand, and the binary numbers are the electrical numbers, digital signals which computer can understand. So we need a translator program which translates high level language into a machine language so that computer can understand it. Now we will learn how we can convert this high level language decimal number to binary. How compiler converts? Let us study. Suppose this is a 160. This is a decimal number. We need to convert it into 01 form. How we will convert? We will learn step by step. First step is divide the number by 2. Then get integer quotient for the next iteration. Get the remainder for the binary digits. Repeat the steps until the quotient is equal to 0. Write the remainders obtained in each step in reverse order to form the binary equivalent of the given decimal number. It implies placing the least significant number top and most significant number at the bottom. Let us learn with example. Suppose 25 is a decimal number. We need to convert it into a binary. How we can do? Firstly, we divide 25 by 2. When you will divide 25 by 2, what you will get the quotient? Quotient will be 12 and the remainder will be 1. Keep in mind, when you will divide 25 by 2, the quotient will be 12 and the remainder will be 1. Then again we need to divide this quotient 12 by 2 again. Again we will divide 12 by 2. Then again we will get the quotient 6 and remainder will be 0. 12 is fully divisible by 2. There will not be any remainder for that. That's why the remainder will be 0. Again, 6 we will divide by 2 again and the quotient will be 3 and remainder will be 0 because 6 is fully divisible by 2. Then 3 the quotient again we will divide the quotient by 2. What we will get? The quotient will be 1 and the remainder will also be 1 because 3 is not fully divisible by 2. The remainder will be there, that will be a 1. Then again we need to divide the quotient 1 by 2. 1 is smaller than 2, so it is not divisible. So when we will try to divide it, then the answer will be in points, means 0.5, but these are integers. We will not write the answer in points. So we will divide it and write the remainder. There will not be any quotient. 0.5 we will not write in points. There will not be any quotient and the remainder will be same 1. We will divide 1 by 2, that is not divisible. Then we can write the quotient as a 0 and the remainder as a same 1. So in this way, after that, this last point, after that we will stop dividing, because when we will get the quotient as a 0, we will stop. 0 or 1, if we will get the quotient 0, then we will stop dividing it for the further. Now this the last term which we have calculated as a remainder, that is the least significant number and the very first remainder which we calculated, that is a most significant number, and we need to write them in top up form, means bottom to top. 25 was the decimal number and its binary equivalent is, we will start writing from least significant number to most significant number, from bottom to top. First 1, then again 1, then 0, then again 0, and then most significant number, that is 1. So the 25 is a decimal number, its equivalent binary number is 11001, which is a binary number. So decimal number is having a base 10 and a binary number is having a base 2. Let us take another example. This is a 321. We need to convert it into a binary form. The process is same, 321 by 2. Quotient will be 160, remainder is 1. Again 160 will be divided by 2, quotient is 80 and remainder is 0. 80 again will be divided by 2, the quotient is 40, remainder is 0. 40 again will be divided by 2, the quotient is 20 and remainder is 0. 20 will again be divided by 2, the quotient is 10 and remainder is 0. 10 again we will divide 10 by 2, the quotient is 5 and remainder is 0. Again we will divide 5 by 2, the quotient is 2 and the remainder is 1. Again 2 divided by 2, the quotient is 1 and the remainder is 0. 1 by 2 is not divisible because 1 is smaller than 2, then quotient will be 0 and the remainder will be as same, that is a 1. So again we will write 321 is a decimal number, its equivalent binary number will be from bottom to top, from least significant number to most significant number. These are from bottom to top, we will start writing 101, then 00000 and then 1. From top to bottom to top we are writing. So these are the 321 is a decimal number and its equivalent binary number we have calculated. Next is we have learnt how to convert decimal number to binary number. Why we need? Because computer can't understand 321. Computer can understand 101 and then zeros and 1. So that for we can't understand 10, human being can't understand 10, 1, 0s, 1. So again we need to convert it into a decimal number. How to convert binary to decimal, this we will learn now. Before starting that, I will tell you how we can calculate the power, because for converting binary to decimal we need to calculate powers. 2 raised to power 4 is equal to 2 multiply by itself 4 times. 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. 2 into 2, 4. 4 into 2, 8. 8 into 2, 16. 2 raised to power 4 equals to 16. 2 raised to 3 means 2 multiply by itself thrice. 2 into 2 into 2, which is equal to 2 into 2, 4. 4 into 2, 8. Similarly, 2 into 2 square is equal to 2 into 2, that is 4. And power of any number, if the power of any number is 0, then the answer will be 1. If we will, the power of 2, if the 2 raised to power is 0, then the answer will be 1. 8 raised to power 0 is also 1. 16 raised to power 0 is equal to 1. Power of any number is 0, then answer will be 1. Keep in mind, if any number's power is 0, then answer will be 1. Keep in mind this thing. Don't confuse. That answer is not 0. Let us learn how to convert binary number to decimal number. To convert binary number into equivalent decimal number, follow these steps. Multiply each binary number with its opposite value, its positional value, which is in term of power of 2, starting from extreme right to digit. Right digit. Increase the power 1 by 1, keeping the base fixed as 2. Calculate the sum of all the products to get the decimal number. So let us learn with example. Suppose this is a binary number 11001. We need to convert it into decimal. How to convert? First, the right hand digit, multiply it by 2. Then next number, second right, multiply it by 2, then next, then next, then next. All digits individually, multiply them by 2. Then give from right to left, start giving the powers. 2, 2 in increasing order. 2 raised to power 0, then 2 raised to power 1, 2 raised to power 2, 2 raised to power 3, and 2 raised to power 4. Start from right to left in increasing order. Then take the addition, then take the sum of all these values. First, 2 raised to power 0, which we have already discussed. 2 raised to power 0 is equal to 1. 1 into 1, 1. 2 raised to power 1 is equal to 2. 2 into 0 is equal to 0. 2 raised to power 2 is equal to 4. 4 into 0 is equal to 0. 2 raised to power 3 is equal to 8. 2 into 2 into 2. 2 into 2, 4. 4 into 2, 8. 8 into 1 is equal to 8. 2 raised to power 4 is equal to 16. 2 into 2, 4. 4 into 2, 8. 8 into 2, 16. 16 into 1 is equal to 16. Then take the sum of all these numbers. The answer is 25. 16 plus 8 plus 1. That is 25. 16 plus 8, 24, 24 plus 0, 24, 24 plus again 0, again 24, 24 plus 1 is equal to 25. This is a decimal. The 11001 is a binary number. Its equivalent decimal number is 25. Hope you have learned this illustration, binary to decimal conversion. Now, comes the octal number system. We have already discussed in a previous session. Octal number system consists 8 digits. Keep in mind, 8 digits 0 to 7, not 0 to 8, not 1 to 8. These are 0 to 7. 0 to 7, total 8 digit octal number system consists. The octal number system consists of 8 digits from 0 to 7 with the base 8. Concept of octal number system came from the Native Americans, as they used to count number by using the space between their fingers rather than using their fingers. The procedure for octal to decimal conversion is similar to binary to decimal conversion that we will learn You can see the space between the fingers. If you will count the spaces between your fingers, that will be 8, not 10. You can see in the picture also. This concept came from there. Spaces between the fingers. To convert octal number to decimal number, start multiplying the digits of the number from right hand side with the increasing power of 8 starting from 0 and finally calculate the sum of all the products. Earlier we have learnt binary to decimal. Similarly, octal to decimal, how to convert octal to decimal, that we will learn in this. So this is a number 345, that is a octal number. We need it to convert it into decimal number. 345, you can see all these individual digits will be between 0 to 7 only. If any number is increasing from 0 to 7, it beyond the limit of that will not be a octal number. Octal number will always having a digits between 0 to 7. So now this is a octal number, we need to calculate its decimal equivalent. How to calculate? Firstly, most right digit 5, multiply it by 8, then plus, then middle means second from right hand side, the second digit 4, multiply it by 8, then third number from right side, from we will start always from the right side, from right side third number is 3 and multiply it by 8, then give the powers 0, 1, 2. Now we will calculate. 8 raised to power 0 is equals to 1. Power of any number is 0, then answer will be 1. 1 into 5 is 5. 8 raised to power 1 is 8. 8 into 4 is equal to 32. 8 raised to power 2 is equal to 64. 8 into 8, 64. 64 multiplied by 3, then will be 192. Then we will take the sum of all these numbers. The answer is 229. So 345 is the octal number and its equivalent decimal number is 229. Now hexadecimal number system. The number consists 16 digits, number 0 to 9 and the letters A to F, where A to F represents the decimal number from 10 to 15. That A means 10, B means 11, C means 12 and so on. The base of this number system is 16. This number system is also known as hex. The procedure of converting hexadecimal to decimal is similar to the methods shown in the previous page, with the only difference being the change the base. To convert hexadecimal number is similar like 18, like octal. To convert hexadecimal number to decimal, multiply the number starting from the right hand side with increasing power of 16 starting from 0 and then calculate the sum of all the products. Let us try 4D2. This is a hexadecimal number. 4, you know, D denotes, we will again I remind you, 0 to 9 and then A, B, C, D, E, F means 10 to 15 are the alphabets which denotes the sum, represents some numbers. Suppose A represents 10, B represents 11, C represents 12, D represents 13 and E 14 and F represents 15. So D means 13. So let us right hand side, the most significant number digit is 2, multiply it by 16. Then 13, D means 13. D is not actually D, that denotes the 13. 13 multiplied by 16, then 4 multiplied by 16, then give the power 0, 1, 2. You know 16 raised to power 0 is equals to 1. 1 into 2, 2. And 16 raised to power 1 is equal to 16. 16 multiplied by 13, the answer will be 208. Similarly, 16 multiply by 16 and then multiply it by 4, then answer will be 1024. Then again we will take the sum of all these numbers and that is a 1234. 1234. This is a decimal number. So the hexadecimal number 4D2, its decimal equivalent is 1234. So in this way we can convert hexadecimal number to decimal conversion. So hope you have learnt all these, how to convert decimal to binary and binary to decimal and octal to decimal and hexadecimal to decimal. In the next session we will learn arithmetic operations on binary numbers, means binary numbers, how we can add them, subtract and multiply, division, these things we will learn in the next session. Thank you very much. Hope you have enjoyed the video.